I love it.
She's somewhere between 10 and 12 years old.
She's perfect.
So you have the joy of joining me in my home office slash games room.
I love it.
Which
love
is
it,
definitely it, used as a games room more often than anything else.
That's what it's for.
Absolutely. So we've got four people in, and let's just fire ahead. Let's hope this works. So everybody's in. I'll just start. Dun, dun, dun. So round one, you have to name the LGBT celebrity. It'll come up with four different options and you just click the one that you think is the correct one. So we have this young celebrity. Can you hear the groove in the background now? No? One left to answer. Ooh, so close. Three out of four is not bad. Yep, that's Elliot Page, who is famous for being in the movie Juno and many, many other movies. But that's the first one I can think of off the top of my head. Oh, Jade's sneaking the lead here. And on to the next one. Again, name the famous celebrity.
It won't last long, don't worry.
Oh, so going through the answers here, Peter Capaldi, nobody went for that. He used to be Doctor Who. Jon Snow is one of the main characters in Game of Thrones. Tim Allen, I half made up, but sort of recognised the name and have no idea why. And Tim Cook is the chief exec of Apple after the passing away of Steve Jobs. Oh, extending the lead. Oh, Jade. Donna's got a bit of catch up to do here.
That was a pure guess as well.
Aye. And on to the next one. How confident are we? Yeah? Okay, one more answer. Oh! So that's Billy Joe Armstrong. He's the lead singer of the punk rock band Green Day. The other two went for Brendan Urie, who's the lead singer of Panic at the Disco. You're on a streak here, Jade. Donna's still on zero. Oh, lots of catching up to do. And next one. Well done. Three out of four got that right. I expect that one to catch most people out. Yeah, Marsha P. Johnson. She was a black trans woman, I believe around the sort of time of the Stonewall riots. I'm not 100% sure. Oh, Wayne, moving up. You're getting chased down here, Jade. Next, we've got another picture here. One of my personal favourites. Big love. Well done, all four. This is my favourite singer, Lucy Spraggan. She was on The X Factor nigh on 10 years ago now. And just a little bit of fanboy, I've seen her 7 times in 4 different countries. What does that do?
That in itself is impressive.
We went out to Paris and it was just a tiny little bar basement and there was about 50 of us at the gig. And oh, it was amazing.
Love it.
Here we go. One more to answer. So that was Christian Nairn. He played Hodor in Game of Thrones. The other answers there, you've got Nick Frost, who's obviously famous for Shaun of the Dead, Hot Fuzz, and Sir Alec Guinness, who was Obi-Wan Kenobi in the later Star Wars films. No one got that one right. But it's okay, there's plenty more. Very famous picture. You can see Jade just dancing away, singing to herself. That is Lil Nas X, yes. Very famous for Old Town Road. And the stats are staying the same. Not much in it though. Next, second last picture here, I believe. That's quite a small picture. I expected that to be a little bit bigger.
I know who it is.
That is Brendan Urie. The one that's not the lead singer of Green Day. Yeah, lead singer of Panic at the Disco and very, very famous bisexual man. Oh, you're running away with it, Jade. 5,500 points.
Trust me, I'm peaking too early. after celebrities, I think I'll fall off the board, trust me.
Right. Okay. Have to hold you to that.
You put a lot of emo celebrities in there, so that's my leg up here. And I mean, come on.
So here we have very, very famous actor, not athlete. Can't imagine him sprinting the 100 metres. That is Jim Parsons, who plays Sheldon Cooper in The Big Bang Theory. The other two have gone for Gavin Mitchell, who plays Bobby the Barman in Still Game. Answer streak of 3 again. Going well. True or false? I will read out the statement and then you just have to say if it's true or false. Gay conversion therapy is still legal in Uruguay. If I didn't know the answer to this, I'd probably have struggled with it. It is false. Gay conversion therapy was made illegal in Uruguay in 2017. Nobody got it right. I think there'll be a few questions that most people will get wrong because I'm evil and write really hard quizzes. Next. The first Pride Parade in the USA was in 1970. It's true. It was 1 year after the Stonewall riots. Half and half. Split opinions. Next up. Grey's Anatomy features the longest running LGBTQ plus character in TV history. True or false? It's true. Our Dr. Arizona Robbins.
Big love for Grey's Anatomy.
It's not something I could ever get into. I've watched a couple of episodes and just never really felt that into it. On to the next one here. The United Kingdom was the first European country to legalize gay marriage. It was false. The first European country to legalize gay marriage was the Netherlands. So well done if you got that right. On to the next one here. The original Pride colors included pink, brown, and black. It's false again. I believe it was just brown and black in the original Pride colours. Correct me if I'm wrong, because that's entirely possible. 2-2 split again. And it was our officer and staff that got it wrong. Big gaps coming out here, but it's okay. There's still lots more questions to catch up. Brazil holds the world record for the largest pride parade in history. It was true. Of course, you get your big carnival in Rio de Janeiro. Pretty hard to beat something on that scale. Oh, well done, Wayne. Catching up. Next. In 2013, an American state was the first in the world to offer a third gender identity on government documents. It was true. The state of Oregon was the first place anywhere in the world to offer the gender identity X as opposed to M or F on official government documentation.
That is wild.
Well done, Wayne.
Yeah, well done. You're not far behind me now. Come on, Wayne, take the title.
Take the title. I mean, you can't win anyway. You're not getting any prizes.
I know I can't win, but I might be able to get bragging rights.
Which is the best prize of all.
Just the best prize of all.
Next. 25 years before Dracula was written, there was a vampire novel named Camilla, based on a lesbian vampire. It's true. And there are large references to it in a movie with Matthew Horn and James Corden called Lesbian Vampire Killers, in which the main character is a lesbian vampire named Camilla. And everyone got that right.
Lauren said it was oddly specific to be false, and also, can we add it to our next FCSA book club reading list?
Absolutely.
My niece did the special effects in that film.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's amazing. I'd quite like to have taken home a prop or two from that movie. Next. Oh, nearly over the 10,000 points mark. Wayne's on a 6 streak, though. You're gonna struggle now, Jade. Next up, We have homosexuality was not removed from the list of mental health disorders in America until 1997. It's one of those ones, it's America, so you never really know for sure. It was false. I don't have written down the exact year they did remove it from the list of mental health disorders, but I believe it was after 97. And Donna was the only one to get that one right. Well done, Donna. Sport and health. There is one question in this entire quiz that isn't based on the LGBT community, and it's this next one. How many points did England fly half Marcus Smith score during this season's Calcutta Cup clash? It was 17. The Calcutta Cup is the rugby game between Scotland and England. Scotland won it this year 20 points to 17, and Marcus Smith scored every single one of England's points. And no correct answers there. Unlucky, guys. On to the next one. Which gay rugby official refereed the Rugby World Cup final before retiring in 2019? It was Nigel Owens. He's a very famous Welsh referee, and he got his 100th cap refereeing the Rugby World Cup final in 2019. He's highly regarded as the best rugby referee in history. One person got it right. Well done, Tally. Did you know that or did you guess?
I feel like I've saw it on the news. I feel like right. I'm a little name, so yeah.
Brilliant. Next up, in 2016, which Olympic team featured the first married same-sex couple winning a gold medal? It was the British hockey team. Kate and Helen Richardson Walsh were the first legally married same-sex couple to win a gold medal ever, and the first since 1920 to be a married couple winning a gold medal in the same event. See, we can set straight records too. No correct answers there. Jade, you're still just behind that 10,000 mark.
I didn't get any points in that round.
That's what, three rounds in a row you've got no points, Jade?
I didn't get any points in that round.
That's ridiculous.
I don't know sport.
Which UK sports star married their same-sex partner in 2017? Tom Daly, obviously Olympic diver. Don't believe they both participate in the same event. Don't even know if his partner's an Olympian. But no, Sir Chris Hoy is the Scottish cyclist. Joe Brownlee is your triathlon. And Andy Murray, married to Kim Murray, the tennis gold medalist. Points almost all round there, guys. Well done. Next. In which city was the largest gay and inclusive Rugby World Championship held in 2018? New York, Amsterdam, Glasgow, or Cairo? It was Amsterdam. The Bingham Cup is the trophy that you get for winning, and they had to fight off competition from London, Manchester, and Edinburgh to hold the tournament themselves. Oh, Jade got that right. Of course Jade got that right.
I was thinking if the Netherlands were the first to do the marriage thing, then maybe it would be another one of those kind of more free countries that would do, I don't know. I was,
yeah,
was
the logic there. It makes
the
sense.
Logic was there.
It was right in the end. They said that they'd been awarded it because rugby hadn't really been played very much in the Netherlands, and it's all about inclusivity. General knowledge. Oh, I could see that look of sadness there, Wayne. Just, oh no.
I'm just worried that I'm not gay enough.
Question one. In which year did laws change to allow members of the LGBT community to serve in the British Armed Forces? It was 2000. Turn of the century. New year, new me, right? Well done again, Jade. More correct answers. Next up, which planet is often used as a symbol by the transgender community? Saturn, Earth, Mercury, or Jupiter? Tough one. It's Mercury. Of course, the planet named after the very famous Freddy. Obviously not. I don't know if Freddie Mercury had some sort of influence on the decision. But...
Lauren and I were like, which one's the prettiest with all the rings on it? We were like, Saturn. She was like, I'm going to hit that. And I was like, Mercury's always in retrograde, so I'm going to hit that.
So it was you that got it right again.
Apparently so. At the last second, I was like, ugh, Mercury's always in retrograde. Let's hit that. She's fair everywhere. Enough.
And of course, Jupiter, the only planet named after a woman.
Didn't know that.
So Jade gets more points, leaves us all in the dust once again. But we'll still catch up. Okay, which symbol was adopted by the lesbian community in the 1970s to represent self-sufficiency and strength? Is it a double-edged axe, crossed swords, a trident, or a purple lightsaber? It's a double-edged axe. Was it Jade that put the purple lightsaber? I could see you.
I was torn between the purple lightsabers and the axe, and I was like,
I was me on the purple lightsaber.
How cool would the lightsabers have been?
It was absolutely, it's the kind of thing we would want to have as a symbol, but...
I thought that, and then I thought about Legacy of
Star Wars.
So...
But congratulations if you got that one right. Jade. Congratulations for getting that one right, Jade. Okay, onwards and upwards. Next. The scale from 1 to 6 on which one can describe their sexual orientation is known as what? The Likert scale, the Thurstone scale, the Kinsey scale, or the H1-H6 scale? It's the Kinsey scale. One representing complete heterosexuality, and 6 for complete homosexuality. And you can be anywhere on that scale. You don't have to be a whole number, you could be something like a 3.97. Congratulations if you got that right. Well done, Donna. The comeback's on. She's coming for it. She's coming for Jade's top spot now. Which was the first Asian country to legalize same-sex marriage in 2019? It's Taiwan. And as far as I know, it's the only Asian country where it's legal at the moment. Unless there's been any recent changes. The only Asian country to legalize same-sex marriage so far. And even that was only in 2019. Okay, nobody got that one right. It is a tough one. Next up, the first gay bookstore in the world was named after which writer? It was, of course, Oscar Wilde, a very well-known homosexual writer. After serving time as a slave for his, I believe they called it public indecency, he adopted the name Sebastian Melmoth after Saint Sebastian, the patron saint of queers. I didn't know we had a patron saint until I looked up that. Congratulations, Wayne. Next up, which country was the first in the world to have an openly gay head of government? Monaco, the Netherlands, Iceland, or Canada? It was Iceland. Forgive my pronunciation, but I believe her name was Johanna Sigurdardóttir, and she was elected in 2009 as the first openly gay world leader, which is absolutely brilliant. You go, Iceland. That's why mums go to Iceland. Congratulations if you got that one right. Next up, multi-select. Which two colours were added to the Philadelphia rainbow flag in 2017? Pink, black, brown, or turquoise? Jammin'. It was black and brown. They reverted the flag back to its original colours for their Pride Parade in 2017. And Jade gets more points. Just as well, Jade can't win, right?
Hey, I've not had points in like six rounds. This is the first time.
Fair enough. The radical queer organisation founded by Marsha P. Johnson and Sylvia Rivera was known as what? GLF, Queer, Star, or ACTA? Ooh, each answer getting one choice. It was Star. And it's an acronym for Sweet Transvestite Actional Revolutionaries. STAR. Well done, Donna, for getting that one correct. Next up, who's known as the Mother of Pride? Is it Sylvia Rivera, Edna Greenwood, Brenda Howard, or Lily Savage? Brenda Howard, the correct answer. Lily Savage, of course, being Paul O'Grady's drag name. Sylvia Rivera, part of Star, and Edna Greenwood, because I couldn't remember Dame Edna Everidge's last name. It's amazing how things come to you when you're writing a quiz. Well done. On to film and television. Here we go. Which of these Glee characters came out to their father in an emotional scene? Brittany, Blaine, Santana, or Kurt? Yep, it was Kurt. All four answers there were LGBT characters in Glee. Brittany and Santana having their little fling for a while, and Blaine and Kurt eventually getting married. It was a very emotional scene and it almost broke my heart, but it happened. I love it. Well done, Wayne and Jade, for getting that one right. Which real-life film prompted Cheryl Blossom to come out to Tony Topaz in the series Riverdale? Booksmart, The Half of It, Love, Simon, or Brokeback Mountain? I don't know if you guys watch Riverdale, but I do watch Riverdale, and even I didn't notice it at first. It was Love, Simon. I believe they went to see it in the cinema and she just broke down. Next. So who got that one right? Well done. Both Wayne and Donna got that one right. Good job, guys. Which teen drama features a couple named Ander and Omar? It was Elite. It's not something I've watched yet, but it's definitely on the to-do list. Congratulations if you got that one right. None of those were particularly well-known shows, I don't think. So, well done. Which song does Patrick perform for David at the open mic night in Schitt's Creek? You can see, Jade, that one hit deep right there.
This was such an emotional scene when I watched it. Like, actual, I'm clicking on the computer screen, actual tears in my eyes.
You're saying
clicking. And then I laughed, cried with laughter when David did it in return a couple of episodes later.
Aw, I've only just started watching Schitt's Creek, so thank you for the spoilers. No, I've had it on my Netflix for months now and just not got round to watching it. It was Simply the Best by Tina Turner. Well done if you got that right. Jack and Will never kissed on Will and Grace. True or false? It was false. Wouldn't really be a gay couple on a show if they hadn't kissed at some point, I'd imagine. I've never seen Will and Grace, so I don't know if they're even a couple. But no, not a couple. Right, okay. My TV knowledge,
couple
limited.
Of besties, but not a couple.
They're besties, right, okay. Will but and they Grace. Have kissed. Okay, yeah. Right. I'll have to stick that on the watch list now as well.
Jack is what they call a platinum gay. And when you watch the show, you'll find out what that means.
Oh, I know what that is. I know that one. Next. In Sex Education, Eric dressed up as which iconic musical character? Forgive my typos. It is Hedwig from Hedwig and the Angry Inch. This is a movie about a transgender woman who had gender reassignment surgery in East Germany during the war. And the surgery didn't quite go to plan, and they were left with an angry inch. It was famously put on Broadway, and the main character, Hedwig, was played by none other than Neil Patrick Harris. It's a brilliant soundtrack, and it's definitely one of my top movies. No correct answers there. Where did Callie and Arizona share their first kiss in Grey's Anatomy? It was the bathroom of the bar. Again, I haven't seen Grey's Anatomy, but Jade seems to like Grey's Anatomy, so I might give it a chance at some point.
There are so many LGBT characters on Grey's Anatomy, like, it's worth a watching.
Okay. My fiancé is crazy into it, so no doubt I'll be forced to watch it at some point, but well done for your correct answers there. Next up, which TV show featured the first lesbian kiss? Was it Seinfeld, LA Law, Full House, or The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air? It was LA Law. I don't know if there's ever been a lesbian kiss in The Fresh Prince. I've watched a lot of it and can't remember there ever being a lesbian kiss. And I've never watched Full House or Seinfeld or LA Law. But the internet is great at finding the correct answers to these questions. Brilliant. Dr. Google. So Wayne was the only one to get that one right that round. Well done. Which TV show was the first to have an openly gay lead character? Ellen, Grey's Anatomy, Chicago PD, or Magnum PI? It was Ellen. Long before what we know as the Ellen show today, it was a sitcom based on her life, and she came out on live television. She hadn't even told her mother that she was gay, came out on live television and became the first openly gay lead character. And Wayne goes right with that one as well. Oh, I think he's going to catch up to you, Jade. You're going to lose your bragging rights. Who said it? This is, I believe, the last round. It'll come up with a quote and you choose which of the four people you think said it. First of all, thank you for teaching me what unconditional love is. You will always be my proudest accomplishment.
I'm sorry to say, I don't know who any of these people are.
I know who one of these people are. So most of you went with Brie Bella, who is a famous WWE wrestling diva. The correct answer was Matt Bomer.
I closed my eyes and hit a button.
I swear most of your points have come from guesswork. It's going brilliantly for you today, Jade. Next up, I'm tired of hiding and I'm tired of lying by omission. That was, of course, Elliot Page speaking on coming out as a transgender man. Ian McKellen, of course, being Gandalf from The Lord of the Rings. Billy Joe Armstrong, the lead singer of Green Day. And Zachary Quinto is, depending on your preference, he's either from American Horror Story or he is Captain Spock. Yeah, Spock. in the new Star Trek movies? Yes, Jade. Live long and prosper. Well done if you got that right. I consider myself to be a free-ass motherfucker. Was that Janelle Monáe, Sarah Paulson, Ezra Miller, or Wilson Cruz? That was Janelle Monáe, very well-known singer. She did the collaboration with the band Fun. And Ezra Miller being the... What's the word I'm looking for?
Are you going to mention his acting career or his musical career?
Acting career.
So they play the... Oh, what's that film with Emma Watson? Perks of Being a Wallflower.
I was thinking of the other one with Emma Watson. One.
I don't know
the
that one.
Fantastic Beasts.
Yeah.
I can't remember what the name for the big black blob is.
I don't know that one. But they also, if anyone's into some good music, they are in a band with a couple other people called They Were Sons of an Illustrious Father, and I think they've just rebranded this year to a more gender-neutral name. But some very good music coming from them.
I'll definitely have to put that on the Spotify liked list. Well done, Donna, getting that one right when no one else did. Well done. Everyone knew me as a gay man. In my life in London, I never tried to hide it. That Luke Evans, Lee Pace, Andrew Rannells, or John Early? It was Luke Evans, famous for being the Beast, not the Beast, for being Gaston in the new Beauty and the Beast film. You might also know him from the Fast and Furious saga, where he plays Owen Shaw. I actually knew that one before Google. So proud of myself. Next. Well done. Points all round there, I think. Nature made a mistake, which I have corrected. That Christine Jorgensen, Harvey Milk, Bayard Rustin, or Sylvia Rivera? It was Christine Jorgensen. Well done if you got that right. Christine Jorgensen was a trans American woman and was the first to be known across the USA for having gender reassignment surgery. Donna and Tally both getting points there. Well done. My silences had not protected me. Your silence will not protect you. That Audre Lorde, Brenda Hubbard, Alexia Salvador, or Alice Uncom. That was Audre Lorde. Who was a self-defined black lesbian mother warrior poet. No points there. Okie dokie, on to the next one. The Lord is my shepherd, and he knows I'm gay. That is Troy Perry. He's an American preacher and founder of the Metropolitan Community Church, which is much more open than most establishments to gay, transgender, lesbian believers. Three people got that right. Well done. Next up, we are powerful because we have survived. That was Audre Lorde again. Another name you might recognize there is Martina Navratilova, who was a lesbian former women's tennis champion. Ooh, lots. That's a lot of points to have racked up overall. I didn't realize that was that many questions. Love and compassion are necessities, not luxuries. That the Dalai Lama, Taylor Swift, Lena Waithe, or Harry Winston. That was the Dalai Lama, the leader, I believe, of the Buddhist faith, I believe. Yeah, I think so. 99% sure. Oh, Donna going right three times in a row. Well done. People will stare. Make it worth their while. Is that Harry Winston, Zachary Quinto, Ellen DeGeneres, or Dolly Parton? That was Harry Winston. Other answers there, Zachary Quinto, again from Star Trek, Ellen DeGeneres from The Ellen Show, and Dolly Parton thrown in there simply because of the amount of augmentation that Dolly Parton's had, and therefore make it worth their while. I thought it might be a bit funny. And I believe that's the last question. Thank you for joining us and congratulations to the winners. This should now show us where everyone finished. Podium. Tally in third. Well done. Wayne in second. And I'm guessing Jaden first.
I'm going to take myself off that because I just wanted the bragging rights.
Okay.
So well done, Wayne, and well done, Donna. You guys have done amazing knowing all of that. And you actually knew your answers, whereas I just guessed mine.
Mine's what guessed, Jade.
Complete luck of the draw.
100%. Well done to yourself.
Well done, everyone.
This was fun. I learned a lot.
All very, very respectable scores. Probably more than I would have got if I hadn't written it. But yeah, so we have Amazon vouchers to send out to you guys. Obviously not to Tally or Jade, but Wayne, you get an Amazon voucher and Donna, you get an Amazon voucher. Well done.
Thank you
so much for joining us. This has been brilliant.
Thanks, guys.
Cheers.